So hi everyone, I welcome you all for the most awaited series of Kingmakers IAS Academy, that is the Protected Areas in News, that is National Park Wildlife Sanctuaries and Protected Areas in News. In this initiative, we'll be identifying 50 protected areas which were there in the current affairs for the past 1 year, and we'll be segregating those protected areas based on their states, and we will be discussing those protected areas with respect to UPSC prelims point of view. So last year also we did the series, it was a very big hit. So again, this year we are planning to conduct the same one. So I have identified 50 protected areas. We are going to see 10 protected areas per video. This is going to be a five video series. So today it is going to be the first part. So today we will be discussing the first 10 protected areas which were there in news. So similarly, we'll cover it in the five videos. Most probably the videos will be coming on the alternative days. Okay. So I have segregated them in the state-wise. So let us go into the video without much delay. So if you could see last year preliminary, there were almost four questions from the protected areas. So this is the in prelims 2020, there was this question regarding the critical tiger habitat. That is the largest critical tiger habitat. We discussed that is Nagarjuna Xylem. We discussed about that. And we also discussed about the Desert National Park and the presence of Great Indian Bustard there. We discussed this also last year. And there was this question. Each year, almost 3 to 4 questions come from the protected areas. So our objective is to hit these areas. So scoring 6 marks or 8 marks in this area will be very much handy in clearing preliminary. So with this note, let us start the 50 protected areas in the new series. So today we are going to see 10 protected areas from Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Manipur, and West Bengal. And first one is about the Debrouz-Saikowa National Park. So Debrouz-Saikowa National Park, it is located in the Assam. Recently, there was a gas leak. That is, in the June month, there was a gas leak in the Bhagjan well in Tinsukia district of Assam. So, in and around this Debrouz-Saikowa National Park, there was a gas leak, and that led to a lot of pollution and destruction of the ecology near the national park. The Bhagjan is a purely gas-producing well, and it is almost within the 1 kilometer of the park. So, it is 900 meters from the park. This gas well is 900 meters from the park. So, easily the gas leak will be affecting the national park. So that is the problem. It has been drilled by Oil India Limited. So a mixture of propane, methane and propylene gas were leaking. So study about the propane, methane and propylene gas also with respect to chemistry point of view. The gas is flowing with the wind up to 5 kilometers. There was a condensate. That is a condensate formed because of the residue of the gas was spreading almost 5 kilometer radius from the leakage site. But this national park is located within 1 kilometer. So that's why it created the problem. It damaged the bamboos, tea gardens, banana trees, betel nut trees, etc. So that it is also an eco-sensitive zone. It is exactly located in the eco-sensitive zone. That is the major issue here. Both Debrouz-Saikowa National Park and Maguri Motapong Wetland. So note down this name, Maguri Motapong Wetland. So that can also be a question from this Maguri Motapong Wetland. So the Maguri Motapong Wetland is located where? Like already we had a question. They gave about Deeporbil. The famous Deeporbil Wetland is located in which state? So this was a question. And they also asked about the Kodaikanal Lake. So similarly, they can give Maguri Motapong Wetland is located in the which of the following state. So that can also be a question, or which of the following national park. So that can also be a question which they can be asking. So be ready for both the things. The gas leak also caused the death of the Gangetic dolphin. So it is Debrouz-Saikowa is located very near to the Brahmaputra River. The Gangetic dolphins in the Brahmaputra River were affected. So yeah, Gangetic dolphin is present both in the Ganga River and Brahmaputra River. Debrouz-Saikowa National Park is a national park as well as a biosphere reserve. It is located in the Brahmaputra River of Assam. It is one of the 19 biodiversity hotspots in the world. So UNESCO's Man and Biodiversity Program has identified 19 biodiversity hotspots in the world, and it is part of the Eastern Himalayas biodiversity hotspot. So it consists of semi-evergreen forests. So asking question based on the types of forest is also a trend which UPSC is following. Which of the following national park is located in the semi-evergreen forest? So this can be a question. In options, they will be giving 4. So UPSC in previous instances also have asked the question. So it is having semi-evergreen and deciduous forest within it. So note it down. And it is also having one of the largest swamp forests in Northeast India. And it is also an important bird area identified by Bombay Natural History Society. Important bird area means it is an important breeding ground or resting ground for the birds. That is the migratory birds which is traveling from other countries. They will also rest or breed here in this area. So if a region is a breeding ground or a nesting ground or a resting ground for a bird, so it can be either a breeding ground or nesting. Nesting na, they will be having their nest or resting. Long distance parakumbodhu nadula, if at all they need any rest, they can also be resting in this particular area. So that is the important bird biodiversity area. And this is the location in the map. Identifying the location in the map will come in handy if there is a question. It will be coming in handy for visualization purposes. Somewhere it will be helpful, and for geography optional, surely it will be helpful. So it is located in the northeastern edge of Assam. So this is where the Dihang River becomes Brahmaputra River. So in that region, we are having this Dibru-Saikhow National Park. So it is in the northeast end of Assam and in the Assam-Arunachal Pradesh border. So this is about the Dibru-Saikhow National Park. The second national park wildlife sanctuary which you are going to see is Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also located in Assam. So in this Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary is known for this golden langur. It is also called as geese golden langur. This golden langur is a primate species, that is a monkey species, which is endangered. So note it down, this golden langur is endangered. It is located in this Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary. So what is the news behind it? The news is that in the recent studies, it was found that there are a lot of infanticide happening in the golden langur. So these golden langur, it was found that the father of the infant, whenever it is born, it is trying to kill the offspring. If at all, if there is a male child, they are trying to kill. At the same time, there is also a lot of abortions going on in the womb. Because of this golden langur, because of the human intervention, they are exposed to a lot of stress, and there is a abortions going on, and that is leading to stillbirths in the golden langur. So that is a sorry state of affairs created by the human intervention. So that is the news. There is a prevalence of infanticide where a father is killing the son once it is born because of the alpha male attitude. And there is also this, because of the human intervention, a lot of stillbirths is happening in this golden langur. And there was another news in 2019 also. In 2019, under MG Narega scheme, they decided to create a reserve forest. So the government used the MG Narega scheme to create a reserve forest in and around Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary so that these langurs can live there. So langurs live in the trees. So for them, they created a reserve forest. For that, they used MG Narega scheme and the funds and the employees through that. So that is the thing. So golden langurs in Assam. So this particular Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary is surrounded by three rivers. That is Brahmaputra River in the south, Manas in the east, and Sankosh River in the west. That is Brahmaputra River is going south like this. Then we are having Manas River in the east and Sankosh River in the west. Manas and Sankosh both are tributaries of Brahmaputra River, and it is located in between. That is Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary is surrounded by three rivers. Note it down. Brahmaputra, Manas and Sankosh River. Sankosh River and Manas River are tributary of Brahmaputra River, right bank tributary of Brahmaputra River, and it is located 2400 meters higher. So Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary in Assam is India's first wildlife sanctuary with golden langur. So golden langur kaga create panna first wildlife sanctuary is that this is golden langur. Paaka golden color skin irukum, but it is a langur variety. Since these varieties live in the trees, for them they are planting trees using the MG Narega fund and the workers from MG Narega. So that's why these species are going to get benefited. So this is the Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary. We are having Manas River, which is coming from Bhutan, and we are also having Sankosh River. So it is located in between both the rivers. So that is the speciality of Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary. Note down the location in the map. So Dibru-Saikhow, we found this Dibru-Saikhow near here, and Chakrasila is here. So note down the spots. So the third protected area is Deing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary. This Deing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary is recently Assam government decided to convert this into a national park. Earlier it was wildlife sanctuary. Now they are giving a promotion it and converting it into national park. In a wildlife sanctuary is a particular species oriented, but national park is in general. In wildlife sanctuary, the human interventions are allowed at certain levels, but in national park, the human intervention and human activities are totally prohibited. So that is the difference between the national park and the wildlife sanctuary. And Assam government decided to upgrade this Deing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary into a national park. The announcement comes just months after the National Board of Wildlife. So recently, National Board of Wildlife also gave an approval for Coal India Limited to do the coal mine. So there is this Deing Patkai Elephant Reserve within this national park. In that elephant reserve, there is a coal mining prospects were there. So National Board of Wildlife gave approval for coal mining. So one side, they are giving approval for coal mining, and other side, they are upgrading it to the national park. Both were contradictory. That's why it was in news. So note it down. Deing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary is also known as Jaipur Rainforest. So it is having the rainforest. So note it down. Type of forest is very important. Whenever you are studying a protected area, note down the type of forest. So that is very important. So Deing is the name of the river, and Patka is the hill. So Patka is the hill. In the foothills of the hills only, we are having this wildlife sanctuary, and Deing is the river which is flowing through this. So that's why it got this name, Deing Patkai. So Deing is the name of the river, Patka is the name of the hill. So it got its name both from the river and the hill. So, okay. So that can be a question, which of the following rivers are flowing in Assam? And in that option, you might be having Deing. So appo vandu, so this is how you'll be using the facts which you are studying somewhere indirectly. Consider the following rivers which are flowing in Assam. Which of the following rivers are flowing in Assam? If that is a question mean, and in the option, you might find Deing. You would have studied the Deing Patka Wildlife Sanctuary is located in Assam. From that only, you have to bring in the inference. So this is how these facts is going to use in the prelims. So prelims like the mari indirect avum vandu, it will be helping you. It is one of the oldest refinery in India, oil refinery in India, that is called as Dig Boy. Oil refinery is located in this Deing Patka Wildlife Sanctuary, nearby it. So it is always having the threat of the oil leak, and it is also having tropical wet evergreen forests. Tropical wet evergreen forests are also called as rainforests. So it is one wildlife sanctuary or national park which is having rainforest in it. So that is very important thing. Only rarely national parks will have rainforest in it. So that is one thing. So once it is getting upgraded into a national park, it is going to be the sixth national park of Assam. Already we are having Kaziranga, Nameri National Park, Manas National Park, Dibau Saikhowa National Park, about which we just now saw, and then Rajiv Gandhi Orang National Park. So these are all the five existing one, and this is going to be the sixth national park once it is declared. So already see, UPSC has asked this question, which of the following national parks lies completely in the temperate alpine zone? Like this, they will be giving the type of vegetation located, and they will ask which national park is located completely in the temperate alpine zone. So this is one of the favorite way UPSC is asking. So you note down which kind of forest is located, whether rainforest or evergreen forest or deciduous forest. Okay. Because UPSC has asked, so that's why you have to see the previous year questions. And this is the area where Deing Patka is located. See, Deing Patka Wildlife Sanctuary is located just in the border of Assam and Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh. The moon may say we are having this. Here we are having Dibrau Saikhowa, and here we saw about the Chakrasila Wildlife Sanctuary. So moon may baton. So remember the locations. So Deing Patka is in use mainly because of the upgradation of national park. So fourth protected area in news is Manas National Park. Manas National Park is one famous national park. It is also a transboundary national park. Transboundary national park means it is shared between both India and Bhutan. A part of national park is also located in Bhutan. See, forests and wild vegetations are not having any borders. Only humans, we draw the borders and call it a separate nation. So recently the scientists conducted the leopard census. Okay. Leopard census vandu they have done in this particular national park. So leopard census nadandirukku. For that leopard census, they are using a new technology called spatial mark resite, SMR. SMR is a spatial mark resite technology. So in 2018 preliminary, we had a questions. The technology called M-stripes is used for studying the population of which of the following animals. So M-stripes is a app which was used for studying of tiger. So tiger pathi padikkaradhukaga vandu it was used, but now so similar model la there can also be a question. M stripe mari or question vandu similar model la they can ask for this one. The spatial mark reside is a technology which was recently used to study the population of which of the following animals, or this technology was used in which of the following national parks. In the mari dimension la you can get a question. And the NGOs are Aranyak, Panthera and WWF India. So Wild Worldwide Fund for India. In the moon perume sendu they have done this research. They have done this leopard census there. They are using this. So idhula enna panna poranga? So tiger will be having something called Rosetta. So tiger oda body la vandu, leopard oda body la you will be having this pattern. These patterns are called as Rosetta. So leopard oda pattern vandu indha mari irukum. Okay. So like this you will be having or horseshoe shape la it will be having patterns. So in the mari pad this technology will be identifying these patterns. So these patterns are unique for each leopard. So based on this studying of these patterns only, they are identifying the leopard population. Census eppadi pandranga na, through camera trap they are using this particular model to do this. Okay. So this this team used 3 years of camera trapping data. Moon varshama camera trap panni they have collected the data from 2017 to 19 obtained from the Manas National Park to study the leopard population. So they are using the rosettes. So rosettes are nothing but the patterns on the body of the leopard, and camera trapping history, GPS locations and individual ID for each tiger leopard. Idu ellame seithu they are using this model called spatial mark resite model to study the leopard population. However, idhula vandu what is the challenge here? What is the challenge is like many other wildlife species, leopards are also exhibiting this issue called phenotypic polymorphism. This phenotypic polymorphism is body color variation. So there is also this color variations in the leopards because of the melanin content. So adanal vandu difference in the melanin content of this leopard might give sometimes wrong data. So adanal vandu this is a challenge for them. Leopards are either having black color circular marks called rosette or melanistic full black. If it is having full pitch black melanin content, it is called as panther. Black panther, we saw the movie Black Panda, Wakanda. So and that is called as black panther. Leopards are either they'll be having rosette. So based on this, so this technology is capable of differentiating the melanistic leopard and the normal leopard by studying differentiating this rosetta. This black marks in the body is called as rosetta. Okay. So remember Manas National Park. Manas National Park is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Okay, it is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. World Heritage Site can be either natural site, cultural site, or mixed site. So when a national park is given a UNESCO World Heritage Site, means it is going to be a natural site. So study the list of natural sites under UNESCO World Heritage Site. Like we are having Kaziranga is also a World Heritage Site. So study about that. It is also a tiger reserve. Manas is also having a tiger reserve within it. It is also having an elephant reserve. It is also called as a biosphere reserve. So tiger reserve, na, there is a special area where tigers are located and tigers are protected. There is a special area where the elephant are located and elephants are protected. So see, what is a national park? There will be a wildlife sanctuary. There will be a tiger reserve. There will be an elephant reserve. So everything will be combined to form a national park and all these things will be the core area. Idhukaprama, they will be creating the buffer area. So like that only, they are eco-sensitive zone they will be creating. So in the mari vandu there will be a project Manas Tiger Reserve, Manas Tiger Reserve, and then we'll be having Manas Elephant Reserve, and then we'll be having a biosphere reserve is also a larger entity da. So everything will be combined to form a national park. Okay, so study the difference between the wildlife sanctuary national parks ellame. It is located in the foothills of the Himalayas in the Assam. It is contiguous with the Royal Manas National Park of Bhutan. Yes, it is a transboundary. It got its name from the river which is flowing, like Deing Patkai. Like how the Deing Patkai got its name from Deing River, it got its name from the Manas River because Manas River flows through this. The significance of the park is it is having the rare endangered species endemic such as Assam roofed turtle, and then we are having golden langur. So if you see last year's question, they asked in which of the following national park we are having swamp deer. So or species oda name kudutittu in which of the following national park it is located nu they asked. So that's why we have to study the, whenever we are studying the species, we have to study the habitat, or whenever you are studying the national park, we have to study the species which is located in it, because there was a question. So pygmy hog, it is also having a critically endangered. So pygmy hog is a critically endangered species. We are having golden langur. Golden langur just now we saw in Chakrasila also, and it is also having hispid hare and Assam roofed turtle. Okay, and it is also having a good water buffalo population also. Water buffalo population over there. So this is the protected areas in Assam. So I've taken this image from the Maps of India. So use this Maps of India website to study about the maps. So Manas is located here in the Bhutan border. See, it is being shared by both Bhutan and India. So here we are having Manas River. Then we are having Orang. Orang is located in the northern bank of Brahmaputra. And Kaziranga is located in the southern bank of Brahmaputra. Lakhowa is located in the southern bank. And then Dibru-Saikowa is located in southern bank. So southern bank or northern bank angrade nama padikanum. So if you could see here, we studied Chakrasila is located in the northern bank. So northern bank of Brahmaputra, southern bank of Brahmaputra. So that is also another way of differentiation which you have to study. So in the mari maps ala vandu you'll be getting from the Maps of India website. So you can go and see that website also. So next protected area which you are going to see is Namdafa National Park. This Namdafa National Park is located in Arunachal Pradesh. So we came to, so with this four national park, Assam is over. Now we are going to start Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh, we had Namdafa National Park in news because they had discovered two new butterfly species in Arunachal Pradesh. So this is from the June current affairs, June 2020 current affairs. Since we see, we are covering from June 2022. We are covering from June 2022, April 2021. So this is the target. Okay, as of now, we'll be covering this. So I'll post another video covering the May, June, July also. May, June, July, August of the 2021 later. Okay. So first in the one year patala. So the two new species are striped hairstreak and elusive prince. So these are all the two new species. So lepidopterists, they are the people who study butterfly. They are called as lepidopterists. So striped hairstreak is located in the Arunachal Pradesh, in the city called Vijayanagar. This Vijayanagar is located in the border with Myanmar. So Vijayanagar is a region in Arunachal Pradesh. It is closer to the border of Myanmar. So there we found a species called striped hairstreak. Then we found another species called elusive prince. Elusive Prince is located. Elusive Prince is also having another. Is also located in Vietnam. It is also having a Vietnam connection. Vietnam le iruka, and we also found in Arunachal Pradesh. There is another species called Black Prince. Earlier it was thought that and the Black Prince oda one of the subspecies. And later now only we discovered that it is a separate species. So there can be a question. The species called Striped Hairstrig and Elusive Prince are belong to which of the following? Butterfly, illana spiders, illana vandu moth, and the mari they can ask a question, or caterpillar. So they can ask what species it is. And they can also ask where the recently these two species were found, in which state. Already UPSC has asked the, they will give you the name of the species, in which state it was found. Already UPSC 2015-16, they used to follow this. They will give a name of the species, it was found in which of the following national park. And the mari kepanga. In 2020 also, they gave swamp deer, which of the following national park. So, Andamari, they can give the name of this striped hairstrig, which is found in which of the following national park? That is in Namdafa National Park. So, this is how we have to study. So, Namdafa National Park is located in the international border of India and Myanmar. It is close, located very close in the Changlong district. It is the only national park in the world. Only national park in the world. So, it is an important fact in the world to have all four feline species. Feline species now, the cat family species. Big cats are we will call feline. Big cat we will call feline species. It is having all four feline species. That is tiger. Tiger, we are having leopard. We are also having snow leopard. We are also having clouded leopard. Naal vidamana species also are located here. So, of course, there is another feline species called lion. Lion is located only in the Gir National Park. So, lion will not be there in Namdafa. But except lion, all the other four species, it is located here. So, that is panther is also located here. So that is one thing. And apart from this, Hoolock gibbons are also located. So Hoolock gibbons is the only ape species which is located in India. Among the India, Hoolock gibbon is the only ape species. It is also found in this region. So Namdafa is known for four feline species and also about the Hoolock gibbons. And now it is known for two butterflies which they discovered recently. So these are all the two things. So striped hairstrig and the elusive prince. So these are all the two species. And this is the Namdafa National Park. See here. Namdafa National Park is located here. This is the Vijayanagar district. Correct? It is located in the border of Arunachal Pradesh. So, this is where the Namdafa National Park is located. So, it is located in Arunachal Pradesh. See, we are having Assam border is getting over here. So, this is full of Arunachal Pradesh. So, next one is about the Popham Reserve Forest. We are seeing a reserve forest now. It is not a national park or wildlife sanctuary or a tiger reserve. It is a reserve forest. Reserve forest, it is a forest reserved for the protection by the state government. A study based on the satellite data has indicated that high rate of deforestation. So this Popham Reserve Forest is having a lot of hornbill population. Hornbill is a large bird species. In the Popham Reserve Forest is having this hornbill population in Arunachal Pradesh. And also it is this hornbill also located in Assam, but this Popham Reserve Forest is located in Arunachal Pradesh and it is known for hornbill population. Because of the high rate of deforestation happening there, this hornbill population also getting affected. So other than the news. Because of the deforestation, hornbill is getting affected. Alarming rate of deforestation with annual loss rate of almost 8.2 square kilometers per year. When the 8.2 square kilometers of land is getting removed. So almost when the 76% of the total area got declined because of the deforestation, illegal logging and ethnic conflict also. Rendu group sanda potukitte irukkadhalum, that is also a problem. Forest under extreme pressure because of agricultural expansion, conversion into the plantation and plant... agriculture expand aayirukku and we are converting this land for plantation and logging. Logging na cutting down the trees. So Popham Reserve Forest is geographically situated in the southwest of the East Kameng district of Arunachal Pradesh. I'll just show you that in the map, you will be understanding. On the east of this Popham, we are having Itanagar Wildlife Sanctuary. Itanagar is the capital of Arunachal Pradesh. On the west, we are having Pakwai Wildlife Sanctuary. It is called as Pakwai Wildlife Sanctuary. It is part of Indo-Burma Biodiversity Hotspot. So Indo-Burma Biodiversity Hotspot is one of the biodiversity hotspot is located in India. So Himalayan, we are having Eastern Himalayas, then Indo-Burma and Sunda lands and Western Ghats. So in the Nalada, the biodiversity hotspot which we are having in India, it is located in the Indo-Burma biodiversity hotspot. Popham Tiger, Popham Reserve Forest is also is an endemic bird area. Okay, endemic bird area, na, a lot of bird species also will come. So see this map here, we are having Pakwai Tiger Reserve here and we are having Itanagar Wildlife Sanctuary here and between this only we are having this Popham National Park in Arunachal Pradesh. So this is the exact location where we are having Popham National Park in Arunachal Pradesh and this is Arunachal Pradesh map. And next protected area is Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary. Again, we are seeing Arunachal Pradesh. Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary is located in the Arunachal Pradesh. Recently, they have discovered a new moth species. Moth species, it is a kind of a butterfly kind of a species. Butterfly or sister. Moth is a shorter form of butterfly. New form of a group of butterfly researchers have found a new moth species and rediscovered another new species in the Tali Wildlife Sanctuary in Arunachal Pradesh. It is a wildlife sanctuary as well as a biodiversity hotspot. So, in the biodiversity hotspot is also part of what? Part of Indo-Burma biodiversity hotspot. It is situated 2,400 meters high in the hill, and it is also having Pange, Sipu, Karing, and Subansiri River. Pange, Sipu, Karing, and Subansiri rivers. All these rivers are tributaries, sub-tributaries of Brahmaputra. Subansiri is a tributary of Brahmaputra. It is a right bank tributary of Brahmaputra. This Pange, Sipu, and Karing are sub-tributaries of Brahmaputra. Note down this name. There can be a question. Which of the following rivers are found in Arunachal Pradesh? Appo vandu Pange, Sipu, and Karing in the word. These rivers will be helpful for us to eliminate. Elimination la kandipa, with that we can find the answer. So, andha mari da most of the cases the UPSC will frame the question. So, this is the new moth species. Adoda peru vandu Metallophia Tallinensis. Metallophia Tallinensis. So, biological name and botanical name and only if it is a very important species you remember. We can't remember botanical name for all the species. Only for the important species we can go for it. So, just have that in mind. So, Tali Valley is again located. It is also part of Indo-Burma Indo-Burma biodiversity hotspot. So, here we saw the Popham Reserve Forest, and here we saw the Namdafa National Park, and here we are having Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary. So, this is how map la vandu position recall pannalam. Yen vandu I am showing in the map na, there can be a question. Arrange the following protected areas from east to west. Sorry, west to east in kekalam, or north to south in kekalam. So, that's why I am showing the location in the map also. So, seeing location in the map is important, because there can also be a question which asks us to align it in the north, south, or east, west. Adanal, if you are seeing in the map, if you are remembering it, east, south, east, west, north, south, ellame vandu you can remember. Okay. So, eighth protected area which you are going to see is Dampa Tiger Reserve and Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary. I have combined two protected areas in a single issue. So, Dampa Tiger Reserve and Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary, it is located again in the, this is located in the Mizoram. Okay, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, we saw three, and now we are going to Mizoram. So, it is located in Mizoram. Union government has launched a project called Green AG Project. So, Green Agriculture Project. So, Green AG Project, it's nothing but Green Agriculture Project. To reduce the emissions from agriculture. Okay, they have launched the Green AG projects to reduce the emissions from agriculture and for sustainable agricultural practices. Where they have launched, they have launched in this Dampa Tiger Reserve and Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary. So, in the Dampa Tiger Reserve, Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary, it is located in the Mizoram. In the region, since it is a protected area, they wanted to do sustainable agriculture. Sustainable agriculture, reducing the amount of CO2 emissions. At the same time, organic farming, they will be protecting. So, organic farming, we can improve the fertility of the soil. So, what is sustainable agriculture? Sustainable agriculture should reduce the CO2 emission. It should form organic farming, and it should also use less amount of water. We should not waste water. That is also sustainable agriculture. And the more sustainable agriculture practices they wanted to introduce, and the project down, it is called as Green AG Project. Okay, Green AG Project. That is this Green AG. So, Green AG Project is launched in Mizoram. Remember, okay. So, to bring at least 1 lakh hectares of farmlands under sustainable land and water management, and almost they are planning to sequester 49 million carbon dioxide equivalent amount of CO2 emissions they wanted to sequester. In the data fact, just see this. And it is a 5-year long project. 2021 and 2026 varikum, they are going to launch this project. So, it is going to expand for 5 years till 2026. Adu mattum niyabam vechukonga. Green AG launched in Mizoram in Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary is a 5-year-long project. It aims to cover 35 villages, including two protected areas. That is Dampa Tiger Reserve and Torthalong Wildlife Sanctuary. They are launching this project. That's why it is in use. Green AG project is funded by, this is another important area. So, we can expect a question from Green AG project. And the question, so not only from the wildlife sanctuary, we can also expect a question from Green AG project. And that they can ask this statement. This particular project is funded by Global Environment Facility under Department of Agriculture. So, it is not Ministry of Environment and Forest, but Ministry of Agriculture, which has launched this project in the protected area, along with Global Environment Facility. Global Environment Facility is an international organization which will just funding. It is an international organization which will help in making arrangements for the funding. So, that is the main aim of this particular organization and other key players are na FAO involved irukku and ministry of environment is also involved okay but it is funded by arna global environment facility and it is executed by ministry of agriculture da and it is also coordination yaar FAO is also coordinating ministry of environment is also coordinating but main agency na ministry of agriculture da so remember that ministry the project seeks to integrate biodiversity climate change sustainable land management in the indian agriculture so agriculture we are integrating agriculture with the biodiversity climate change and sustainable land management practices so that the agriculture is becoming sustainable through green energy projects so that's the objective of this scheme so we also saw the protected area that is Dampa tiger reserve and Tortolong located in Mizoram and we are also discussing this scheme rendume paakrom question edhula vena varalam so Dampa tiger reserve is located in Mizoram it is part of the tiger project tiger so recently there were no tigers found adu tiger reserve irundhalum we couldn't find any tigers according to the latest tiger report so inga da vandu Dampa tiger reserve is located and Tortolong wildlife sanctuary is also located here so rendume vandu Mizoram la da located a irukku it is not same contiguous area idu vandu separated area da Dampa tiger reserve inga irukku Tortolong wildlife sanctuary is located near Lungley okay I've just taken the map ana exact map kadaikala adanal I'm taking from the Google Maps and the ninth protected area which you are going to see is Bhagwan Mahavir National Park Bhagwan Mahavir National Park as it is very easy it is located in Goa with this we have come to the end of Mizoram now we are going to Goa so Goa land we are just seeing only one protected area that is Bhagwan Mahavir National Park why it is in news recently a new species of Indian moraine grass na onnu illa it is a kind of a lemon grass mari da lemon grass na vandu people are using in the gardening also so it is a kind of a lemon grass it that is Indian moraine grass known for its ecological and economic importance such as fodder it is used as fodder for animals used to eat it it has been discovered in Goa which is part of Western Ghats okay so Western Ghats la irukra so Bhagwan Mahavir is located as a part of Western Ghats da but in the Goa area so these species are adapted to survive in the harsh condition low nutrient availability so even though there is no nutrients because higher ranges of Western Ghats we will not be having good nutrients for the plant growth so ange vandu it is able to grow and it blossoms every monsoon so this is the speciality consider the following statement regarding indian moraine grass and kudutittu this moraine grass will blossom only in the monsoon blossoming in the monsoon na flowering so flowering will happen only during the monsoon time so indha mari there can be a statement so note on that also so the species is name adoda scientific name kuduthirukanga which is not required just we'll see okay Isachimum janarthanam janarthanami so professor mk janarthanam who is a professor of botany in goa university he is very important with respect to indian grass taxonomy he has done a lot of research with respect he is a botanist who studied about grasses and he has done a lot of documentation regarding the floristic diversity of goa goa ode pookal pathi pannirukkar so adanalu vandu so they have into honor janardhanam they have given the name called Isachimum janarthani okay so it also grows in the low altitude also it grows in mahavir bhagwan mahavir national park so national highway 4a so national highway 4way passed through the bhagwan national park bhagwan mahavir national park idu valiya national highway 4way so national highway 4 connects endha region it connects the bombay with chennai so the national highway which is connecting mumbai with chennai is highway 4 and the highway 4 oda one of the sub road da vandu 4a this 4a passes through the bhagwan mahavir national park so it is also having one of the important location okay important temples of kadambas so kadambas ingra tribal groups are located here okay kadambas are the tribal group which are located in the national park there is an additional fact which can also be a question and it is also having this Doodhsagar falls and Thambadi falls Doodhsagar fall na that famous falls adhaavadhu or periya waterfalls irukku and there will be a railway track in the chennai express padathile varum so or periya waterfall kila or railway track pogum so that is Doodhsagar falls and Thambadi falls both are located here so idha vandu initially they called it Mollem Game Sanctuary now they are calling it Bhagwan Mahavir National Park okay so this is the map Bhagwan Mahavir National Park is located here in the Western Ghats and if you could see highway number 4way is going here so that is the thing which you have to note then Gomura National Park next we are having Gomura National Park Gomura National Park means it is located in West Bengal now we are seeing the West Bengal so Gomura National Park is located near Siliguri corridor la located irukku recently sniffer dog so police use pannuvaangala sniffer dog mopanai that is called a sniffer dog the dog name is Orlando and this dog belongs to Belgian Malinois dog so Belgian Malinois dog it has found a first case so or bison poaching bison na vandha and periya erma maadu which is used in the Bahubali movie also that large bison which comes in Bahubali movie So that is bison. There is used to be a bison poaching in the northern Bengal, and this dog has found the carcasses of the bison, and it found the people who are doing the poaching of this bison. They were killing this bison and they were eating it, and this dog sniffed it and found the poachers, whoever killed the bison. So this is the first case has been clogged. So Orlando is the name of the dog, and it is belonged to Belgian Malinese family, and this incident occurred in Gowramurra National Park, where the carcasses of the bison was found. So this is this Belgian Malinois dog, and it is called as Orlando. Poaching it has founded. So that is the news, but it took place in the Gowramurra National Park, which is located in West Bengal. This Gowramurra National Park is also, since it is located in Siliguri, it is in the foothills of near Himalayas, submountain Terai belt, and the Terai region of Himalayas, and the Shivalik Oda bottom area it is located. Okay, it is also having the riverine grassland, and the grasslands are called as duars in West Bengal. Okay, it is also having the riverine grasslands there. So this national park is having grasslands. These grasslands are called as duars. Duars is a name given to grassland. So grasslands are called as ororurla campos, pampos, and the mari la irukala weld, and the mari vandu it is called as various names in various countries. In India, we are calling this grassland in this national park as duars. So this park is flooded by Murthy River. There is this Murthy River and Raidak River. Both Murthy River and Raidak River and another are flowing through this national park. Another major river is the Jaldaka River. This Jaldaka River is a tributary of Brahmaputra. Jaldaka is the major river which is flowing through this national park. In the Jaldaka, our sub-tributary is the Murthy River, Raidak River. So, in case we saw the names of a lot of rivers. I'll post the notes of the session. So, once we complete all the 50, I'll post the notes in our Telegram channel. Then you open it and see the names of the rivers. Now, you can also rewind the video and you can also see the names of the rivers and take a notes out of it. Okay. So, it is also having a watershed. So, it is also a significant watershed between the Ganga and Brahmaputra. Why it is called as watershed? Na? See, this is Gowramurra National Park. This Gowramurra National Park, eastern side, we are having Brahmaputra system. In the river system, this is Teesta River. And here we are having this Jaldaka River. In the Jaldaka River, it is part of Brahmaputra system. And in this side, we are having Ganges system. So in the Rendu system, this is acting as a watershed. Watershed means which divides the two river system. That is called as watershed. So Gowramurra National Park is located in the Siliguri corridor. This is called as Siliguri corridor. So in the Siliguri corridor, we are having it. Okay. So, okay, guys, with this note, we have come to the end of today's session. In today's session, we discussed 10 important national parks which are located in Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Goa, and West Bengal. So, today we have come to the end of the part 1 of the video. I will be posting part 2 of the video on Friday. On Friday evening, 5:30, the part 2 of the video will be live in the channel. On part 2 of the video, we will be covering another 10 protected areas in the news. So, like that, in 5 parts, we will be covering the 5 protected areas. See all the videos, revise it before the preliminary examination, because seeing one is equal to seeing none. You have to revise it again before the preliminary examination. So, thank you. We'll meet on Friday.